make it happen. And so time went by, and next thing you know, we are making it happen. So when I come here, I feel like it's escorrega. I say, man, you gotta come here to see it. I did it. You know, my students know you. My students train just like your students train. We have the same teachers on the mat, so we do our best to keep the same values at my school and at his school. So when I step in here, I feel home, and I do feel home. Feel very proud of everything you have built
for him on the process that he was going through to get this place in Upperton. I was sharing his like how anxious he was and how excited he was to make this happen. Almost like every step of the way, we had a phone call, we were talking about it, and to see this thing here, it's really inspiring and motivating so we can continue to do our work. So thank you guys for all the support, everything you've done for him. You know, we are in great hands, and let's get started. Thank you.
Professor is doing a good job here. It's not like he's showing the arm. So if you are on the bottom and you do something like this, it's very easy for the person on top to wrap the arm, to block your hip, get them off south, posture up, and work on a submission like the armbar. But when you train with someone that do not panic on the bottom, keeps his elbows in, takes his time to escape, it's challenging to work on the submissions. We'll begin just with that simple drill. Instead of staying here with the side mount, let's move a little bit higher to the north-south control here, okay? I use that also because a lot of times I spar with bigger guys. So for instance, if I am sparring with Fly, he can simply throw me on the wall. I find that their elbows will have more power on that angle here, but when I shift to that angle, they're not that strong anymore. And I keep my chest heavy on their chest, and the way I control, I like to go around the elbow, keeping my elbow tight to their shoulders, and I grab on the belt. If I don't have the belt, I try grabbing on the pants, and I lock my elbow. And I do the same at the other side. So this is a control I use very much. Now we'll just work on a simple drill where our goal is to get underneath the elbow, see? And then underneath the armpit. And then sneak our hands underneath his wrist. If we had room to make it happen, it would be great. We would almost always catch the submission because it's a very good spot to be when you have armpit control and you are under the neck. There's so much you can do from here. You can lock your grip on your wrist. You can control his wrist. You can hold your own collar. You start putting pressure, trying to turn him on his side a little bit. See? From here, it's hard for him to stay safe. Here, okay? And then we gotta do the switch into the keyboard. Keep your elbows tight. Circle to north-south, post. Your partner's gonna grab the collar, you're gonna go up, out, break the grip and finish. Then you bring it back, your partner grabs the elbow, up and out does not work anymore. And he goes to the floor, control that lapel, and keep it tight, okay? Then you're gonna move from here to keep, if it was for real, I'll keep my weight on him, circle, knees on the floor, so I have the balance to do the final two, all right? Let's give it a try, guys.